A letter of instruction by Joseph Smith 3 part 9 by assuming that two of those ordained to the office of president of the high priesthood are but counselors to the one, and that at the death of the one the office and authority of the counselors cease, the equilibrium is destroyed. If they were counselors only, and not entitled to act in any other role or capacity, they being counselors only to the president removed by death or deposition, they cannot as such counselors act in association with either the 12 or the 70 or the high council in Zion, they not having been ordained as counselors to such offices. There is no rule of law or logic that warrants such a construction of church procedure, and it would perforce be a singular stretch of courtesy that would continue them as counselors to living authorities when their office as counselors had passed by reason of the death of their principal. As such counselors, they could not demand that the president of the 12 or the 7 presidents of the 70 should accept their offices as counselors, nor could these authorities demand their presence and assistance upon the supposition that their ordination to their dead principal had given them warrant for such demand. As members of the quorum of the presidency continuing in the discharge of the duties as presidents of the high priesthood, according to the terms of their ordination to such office until such time as the office made vacant by the death or defection of the president of the church is again filled by revelation, choice, and ordination, and themselves or others chosen as associate presidents of the high priesthood, there need be neither difficulty nor danger of a lapse of unity or a fear of conflict of authority. There is danger if other course of action is taken. Observing the premises laid down at the beginning of this letter of instruction, there need be no hesitancy in accepting the views expressed in these answers and adopting the course therein set forth. Assuming the right seemingly conferred in the revelations contained in the Book of Doctrine and Covenants and conforming to the safer principles enunciated in the legendary teaching of the eldership, I, Joseph Smith, the present incumbent of the office of President of the Reorganized Church, definitely designate my eldest living son, Frederick Madison Smith, as the proper person to be chosen by the Church as my successor in office, believing as I do that the Spirit of Revelation and Wisdom has manifested to me that such choice should be made as directed by the Spirit of the Great Master Builder. The present incumbent of the office of President of the Reorganized Church states further that he has trust and confidence in that Spirit which called him to the position which he has held for the last half century of time, and more, that such manifestation will be given to the several eldership of the Church as will confirm the advice and direction herein given. He, therefore, submits this letter of instruction to the careful consideration of his associate officers and members of the Church in the work instructed to the care of the Reorganized Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Joseph Smith, Independence, Missouri, March 4, 1912.